Hey guys, what's up? It's Zach and Fly Jake, and today we're going to be discussing the DayZ status report that came out today on August 28th. This status report was a lot of focus on sort of the Xbox release happening tomorrow. There was some hidden, subtle, good information in there that I want to talk about to you guys, and hopefully you guys find some excitement in that. And just, we're all looking forward to the future of DayZ. And hopefully the future is bright, you know, only time can tell, and we'll have a version 1.0 coming out by the, you know, at the end of the year, and around, you know, when that comes out, whether it has all the features we want, we'll be able to feel the base game, we'll be able to feel is this a good game, and the mods will be hopefully rolling in, and hopefully the ball gets rolling, and we see what other stuff is coming, and just we can sort of, you know, finally feel out, is this game, you know, going to live up to the expectation that the developers have put into it. So let's get right into it. Start off, basically, if you guys didn't know, the devs have been preparing and at GamesCon for the past, you know, couple days here, doing a lot of work there, showing features off. The game was playable on PC, Xbox, and PS4. People were able to try it on all three. It's the first time it was ever playable on the PlayStation. Apparently, it runs fairly well on there, and people have been able to get their hands on the Xbox version as, I believe it was last week, they gave out around 5,000 keys for players to get into the closed access to Xbox. And it's running really well. It looks really nice, and everyone's pretty blown away at how it runs on consoles. Now, there are still, of course, the normal issues, as it is having all the issues that the PC is currently having. But the devs said that they've made, and I quote, huge progress on some of the huge issues in the past week. So even though some of the devs have been at GamesCon, much of the development team has been back in the office, still working on the game, apparently working up to 16-hour days, which is honestly just crazy and way too much time to be working. But I guess that's what you run into when you're really trying to get a game out by the end of the year. So you guys got to know these devs are working hard on, and they definitely have belief in their project. So don't just think these guys are willy-nilly just putting something out with no effort. They really are trying. So let's try to give them the best support we can, or at least not try to bring their spirits down. Back to the Xbox news, a lot of the progress here or talked about in the status report was that the Xbox release for early access is coming on the 29th, August 29th. That is tomorrow as of when I'm recording this, although probably today if you're watching the video. So that's at 7 p.m. CEST time, and the cost will be $39 USD or $39.99, which, I mean, a little bit on that cost there. I think it's a bit pricey. But they say that the max cost is going to be $50, and the fact that we're only, you know, 4 to 5 months away from 1.0 coming out, I think $50 is a fair price for the final version of the game. I think early access right now should probably be closer to 30, maybe 35, but I think the idea of the developers is that since we're only, you know, 5 months away from the full release, we, you know, they don't want to be giving a huge discount when a lot of the people will be getting in the game. Now, I'm not saying that's right or wrong. I'm just giving you a little insight to the timeline of when these prices will be going up and down. Those prices were announced today, and I don't think the final price is too bad. Like I said, I think this is a little expensive for the early access, but hey, it is what it is. Also, a little bit of, you know, this status report didn't have a ton of content in it on the surface, but if you really dug in a little bit, they had an interview they gave out with Barely Infected. You guys should check that out if you look at the status report. It's at the bottom. There's part one and part two. He interviewed them at GamesCon, and they said this in the interview, and they kind of mentioned it in this status report and the last one, so it's pretty much confirmed that the features are complete internally. They basically have an internal build that has, you know, 99% or 90% of the features they want in 1.0 already in there. A lot of people were thinking, you know, gosh, we just got scopes finally. We're only 5 months out. We're still missing vehicles. We're still missing a lot of, you know, some of the weapons. We're still missing a lot of loot. A lot of these things, leaning, vaulting, all these things we're missing still from the game. You know, how are they going to get this stuff done? And while I will say it does seem like there's a lot to get done in the next 4 or 5 months, hearing them say, hey, look, yes, there's still tons and tons of bugs that are game breaking, but internally, we have everything implemented and to some extent, you know, playable. And that's believable considering we've never actually had the helicopter in game. But yet, you know, over a year ago, they had demoed the helicopter. So obviously part of it works. People have already been able to hack in vehicles to the game, and they work to some extent already. Actually, they work pretty well, probably better than they ever did in 0.62. So a lot of stuff is there. They just want to iron it out, better than ever and get it back into the game. And I mean, hopefully this is really as good as it sounds. I don't know if it's just a, you know, a false light at the end of the tunnel. But hearing that all the features were complete internally was just a really good thing to hear. And when I say all the features, I mean all the features that they want for 1.0, because this game is not going to have, you know, every single DayZ feature in 1.0 and then they're done developing it. Basically, 1.0 will be when they say, this game is fun, everything is stable in the game, you know, you can now work on modding, you can now have community servers, private servers, all these things. We're at the final price, it's on all Xbox full release, PC full release. And it's just a stable, good experience overall. And then DayZ will be continued to develop for many years after this. I would say at least 2 to 3, and likely 4 to 5. And then on top of that, what's really going to keep this game alive is the mods. I don't expect the dev team to be doing anything magical keeping the game alive. And if you guys are interested in how these mods, you know, if they'll keep the game alive, why does anybody think it will? I'm going to be releasing a video later this week, so make sure you subscribe to check out that video, where I talk about, you know, could mods save DayZ? And because I know a lot of you guys watching this right now are probably, you know, you're not like wanting to punch that like button. You're probably pretty pissed off at the DayZ development team just for what all has taken so long in this game. And all I can tell you is this, you've got to trust the dev team to put out a stable game. They will do that at some point, and they will also release a very good way of modding the game. So if you believe that, you know, the original mod was so much better for DayZ, this is kind of the video for you to reaffirm. I think you're right. The original mod may have been better, and modders may do a better job than the dev team. Who knows? And if you're right about that, well, who knows? That could save the game. So let's, you know, make sure to subscribe and check out that video. Lastly, guys, also, they said that DayZ modding will work similarly to as it does in Armor 3, which Armor 3 is basically only held together right now by mods, as far as I know from the community. And that's how Armor 2 DayZ, you know, Armor 2 was majorly popular because of the DayZ mod, obviously. Also, guys, I want to go ahead and read this quote from the dev team. As for when modding will be available, we aim for a partial release together with beta. However, this is not set in stone, so I guess I don't really know how a partial release will work with beta. I guess that means maybe not all the easy-to-access features of the modding workshop that will be in Steam will be accessible, but most of them will be, or some of them, or whatever. I think any extent of it will be good, considering, you know, modders are really good at doing magic with whatever they can get their hands on. So let's hope that comes out with beta. You know, go on Twitter, encourage these devs to make sure to have the mods out with beta. Don't be annoying, but I'm just saying, I think that some encouragement for that, it will be good, and hopefully they know what they're doing. Personally, guys, as much as the status report didn't have a ton of content, I understand it. Like, most of these developers have been in GamesCon for the week. Last year, in fact, they actually, after GamesCon, they decided to delay it by a week, and at least we got one this week. Hopefully the one in, 2 weeks from now, it'll be, 2 weeks from today, there will be another status report, and hopefully we get a lot more content and animations with that one, because, you know, like I said, if all these features are there internally, let's see some of it. And I know a lot of it's not, like, it's not even that impressive to see, because realistically, we've had a lot of these features in 0.62, but a lot of us have been playing 0.63, which is, of course, missing a lot of features, and we're excited to see them come back. So any sort of teasers we can get, seeing the new animations for people crawling into the V3S vehicle, and all this stuff is just really good to hear. Also, guys, I wanted to go ahead and point out, there was one thing I was excited to hear in the interview that Barely Infected did with the DayZ dev team. He basically was asking about vehicles, and he said, you know, is there going to be lots of vehicles, but yet they're hard to repair, or is it going to be hard to find vehicles, and they're going to be easy to repair? Personally, I was hoping that they would be, lots of vehicles, you know, that there would be lots of vehicles and it would just be a challenge to repair them. And that's what they're planning on. They said that hopefully the idea is that there are plenty of vehicles across the server. It's just that you have to work hard to get them running. And when you do, it's super rewarding. They also said the vehicles are going to be so much more fun to drive than they ever have been in 0.62. And you won't have to worry about every tiny bump busting the entire vehicle apart. That is it for the status report, but you guys should stick around because I'm going to be giving you guys a bonus clip here. I had a really cool interaction at that military camp I was at earlier in the video, if you saw in the footage. Basically, I ran into two guys on the east side, and they started to shoot at me. I saw them aim. One goes prone in the field, and the other one begins to flank me. It was a 2v1, and I won't say I did amazing, but it was quite interesting, and I think it's worth watching. So make sure you guys please drop a like on the video. Every like helps, and I'm sure there's a couple hundred of you watching. So I hope to see all of you drop a like, drop a subscribe, and I want to see all of you guys in the comment section. Hope to catch you all in my next live stream or video. Enjoy the clip. One's dead.